Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We take up another verse from Bhramar Geet, a collection of devotional verses written by Surdas, who was a 16th century Hindu devotional poet and singer known for his lyrics written in praise of Krishna. They are written in Braj Bhasha, one of the two literary dialects of Hindi. Surdas was a part of Bhakti movement spreading across the Indian subcontinent. This movement represented essentially spiritual empowerment of the masses, an approach to God through bhakti, devotion, kirtan, bhajan kirtan, etc. In Bhramar Geet, Surdas has included verses describing Uddhav visiting Braj to convey Krishna's message to gopis who had been left pining for him when he suddenly left for Mathura. Uddhav is conversant with yoga and Brahmagyan and is not even distantly conversant with amor, prem. When the gopis, still disturbed with Krishna's departure, emotionally disturbed, inquire of him about Krishna, Uddhav talks of the formless Brahma and yoga. This irritates the gopis, who angrily compare Uddhav with a black bee which has just droned into the crowd. The gopis are chanting Krishna's name again and again, and in every verse of Bhramar Geet, Uddhav highlights this fact that for the gopis, none else in the world matters than Krishna, whom they have lost, at least from Braj to the city of Mathura. The verse that we take up today reads, श्याम मुख देखे ही परतीत, जो तुम कोटि जतन करी सिखवत, जोग ध्यान की रीत. We will have faith in you only when we look at Shyam, and you are not accompanied by Shyam. He stays back in Mathura. You may try 1,000 ways to teach us yoga, the worship of Nirguna Brahma, but we are not very intelligent and we cannot believe you. Nahin kachu syan gyan mein hum ye kaise mane. Kahu kaha kahiye ye nabh ko kaise urme aanai. Is asim akash, अर्थात शून्य और ब्रह्म के संबंध में क्या कहा जाए, किस प्रकार इसको समेट कर अपने छोटे से हृदय में हम बसा लें. अवर हार्ट हैज नो स्पेस फॉर द वास्ट कैनोपी ऑफ ज्ञान ऑफ निर्गुण ब्रह्म. यह मन एक एक वह सूरत भृंग कीट सम माने. वी हैव ओनली वन हार्ट, वन माइंड. We are like a small insect. Our heart has got an image of Shyam Sundar. We are molded by his love. We think of him. We think of the Ras Leela enacted by him with us. We think of the love he showered upon us. Sur Shapath Dai Bujat Udho Ve Braj Lok Sayane. We, the gopis, intelligent gopis of Braj, put you on oath and ask you a question. When Krishna and our hearts have merged with each other, how can we perform yoga sadhana? यह मन एक एक वह सूरत. We think of Krishna all the time. We love him. We worship him. We want him back. If you bring him back, we'll talk to you. His presence pervaded all our lives in such a fashion that we have become one. You may try your best. You will not be able to convert us, Uddhav. Bhramar Geet is a fabulous combination of virha, the grief of separation, gyan and bhakti. It is a composition in the face of which gyan takes a back seat. Here the entire logic of yoga accepts defeat. All that remains is absolute devotion, bhakti and bhakti alone. Gopis assert, in the words of Surdas, that human beings can get mukti, that is salvation, with Krishna's blessings. Sincere bhakti is superior to gyan, yog, karma bhed and chati bhed. As a poet, Surdas primarily delved in the rasa of vatsalya, Shringar and Shant. Vatsalya is childhood. Shringar is amor, love. Shant is peace. With Surdas's burning intelligence and imagination, he has painted the childhood of Krishna in luminous colors. Somehow I cannot believe that he was blind. There is so much color used in his verses. But be that as it may, the facts are facts. Surdas's descriptions are beautiful, alive, and psychologically enriching. His Krishna is an embodiment of love and sweetness. He combined bhakti and shringar to describe union and separation with an intensity seldom achieved anywhere. Bhramar Geet is not only one of the most sublime writings on virha and shringar, but is also a unique discussion on sagun and nirgun Brahma. in the conversation between the gopis and Uddhava, we find a witty repartee and penetrating satire. I close here today. I shall be back with another video very soon. Another verse, another video. Thank you for visiting this site. Thank you for listening to me.